Good afternoon, everyone. In today's video, I'd like to talk about an active squeeze setup in LAM Research. That's ticker symbol LRCX. And the overall setup that we're looking at is for this squeeze right here to fire long. We had our first trigger signal happen yesterday. That's the slingshot squeeze right here. You can see that with the yellow arrow. Using the slingshot squeeze, we have our back tester right here. And we're currently measuring 5 years on a daily time frame chart. So over the past 5 years, we've had this setup, the bullish slingshot squeeze, trigger 8 times. Out of those 8 times, all 8 have been winners, with each trade being good for an average of 5.83% and lasting on average a total of right around 5 days. So that gives us our why, the reason we're looking at LRCX on a bullish scenario, our reason for our bullish bias. Now comes in the idea of trying to pinpoint what is our entry price. Now there's 3 different ways that you could look at this. The first is using the actual candle in which we had the trigger signal and using the closing price of that candle. That's option number 1. Option number 2 here is using our market pulse line. That's this line right here. That's a free indicator. You can use that, which is a good substitute for moving averages. Gives you a pullback opportunity. And option 3 is using our volatility box, which is the one that gave you the best entry price. That's where the overall idea with the volatility box is using intraday volatility to try and capture really nice reversal points for the rest of the day, where in stocks where you already have overall longer term bias, you can enter them into our platform and let that do much of the heavy lifting. So let's summarize each of these 3 options really quickly before we dive a little bit deeper. Option 1, again, was using the closing price of the trigger candle. That was 552.45. And your current P&L on that, using our current close price of 548.03, is that you're down 1%. So not a whole bit of heat, but still, you're currently down. Option 2 is using the market pulse line. That gives you an entry at 550.93, but you're still down right around 1%. Now, option 3, where you use the volatility box, you have 2 different models that you could have used. With the aggressive volatility box, the entry price was 531.95, which was hit today, so you did have an opportunity to enter at this price. You're currently sitting on a nice gain of 3%, and if you use the conservative volatility box, that was an entry price of 525.71, that was also hit. That gave you a nice gain of 4% right now, or at least unrealized gains that you're sitting on based off of the current close price. And so the real takeaway that I'd like to call out here is the idea of using intraday volatility in any one of these stocks. We capture that using the volatility box. If you have a different way of doing that, you can use that same approach. But the idea is to use intraday volatility to pinpoint those exact zones where you expect reversals to happen and take advantage of those zones whenever they present themselves. In our case, we can also outsource much of this with our volatility box platform, where you can just come in, add LRCX to your watch list inside of the alerts tab, and you'll get a notification anytime it breaches our volatility box. That really allows you to automate much of the trade management, at least in terms of entries and exits, but we'll talk about that when we get to the actual volatility box discussion. So let's start first with our charts here. We'll come into our daily time frame chart. Let me quickly summarize those 2 prices before we dive into the volatility box. Option 1 was, again, using our closing price, which was right down here on our trigger candle. Option 2 was using the market pulse line, which the first time we hit the market pulse was in today's candle. And option 3, if we come into a 1-minute time frame chart of LRCX, we really had 2 different volatility boxes breached here. We had our aggressive volatility box, which was breached this first cloud right here. And we also had our conservative volatility box breached. So really the way you can think about that is 2 different places to try and scale into this position in which you have longer term bias. You're looking at discount zones to try and get long, especially on a sell-off day. Today you had an opportunity to enter at a price better than the market pulse, so better than the 2 options you already have present to you. And we had the aggressive volatility box breached, and we had the conservative one breached. So you can take your pick based off of whatever your risk tolerance might be like, or you can layer into half of your position at the aggressive volatility box for this longer term trade, and the second half at the conservative volatility box. You can skew that based off of whatever you look like. Now, from each of these entry prices, our target is the other side's volatility box, which in today's case we had the aggressive volatility box breached. This is that first point we're looking at taking off our target, the gray dashed line. And our second place is really that conservative volatility box on the opposite side, which you'll notice price action hit our aggressive volatility box. Then we had a bit of chopping around sideways, a bit of a pullback. And finally, we rallied and this time broke past the aggressive volatility box again into our conservative volatility box. So now using our conservative volatility box entry price, you'll see if you use the move from our conservative entry to the conservative target, that gave you a move of right around 4.33% just for the day that you ended positive in a stock in which you have overall long-term bias. And if you're looking at still participating in a longer-term scenario, that means you can still pad up your overall percentages where you're still looking at that 5.48% entry off of the daily time frame chart, or target, excuse me, off of the daily time frame chart. You've now appended that with another 4.88% right here, really looking at closer to 9 to 10% depending on your entry and exit prices in LRCX. So hopefully this gives you an idea of how you can use intraday volatility like this right here to pinpoint the reversal zones that you expect to see, especially in stocks that you have overall longer term bias. Now comes in the idea of how do you repeat this. So first off, before we move on to the idea of repeating this, this setup is still active. You still have an opportunity to enter at a price better than that 552 closing price from that trigger candle. So this is still a better entry price than the backtester. Just calling that out for anyone who's still interested in Lam research. But for all of our stock volatility box members, you should have had a really nice opportunity to get long today at these entry prices when it either appeared on our live scanner, or you can add it inside of the alerts tab as well. Now comes in the idea of doing homework for tomorrow's batch of symbols, or for the rest of this week, right? So far we have all of these stocks right here. Let's come back into our daily time frame chart. Let's load in our Slingshot Squeeze backtester one more time, and let's try and see if we can find any stocks inside of the Slingshot Squeeze backtester that's looking good for any future moves. So we have our first symbol right here. That's two winners, four losers. We can skip that. Our second symbol right here, three winners, one loser. That's Crown Holdings. We can go ahead and add that to our alerts list right here. So we'll add in CCL. Perfect. So now the platform will take care of that for us. We have WMB, one winner, zero losers. Sure, we can take a gamble on that in case we did get that discounted entry. We can let the platform notify us. NNN, two winners, one loser. Same thing, we can add that in as well. And then finally, we had DRI, which was up a whopping 8% today. Two winners, one loser. So same thing, we can add that in as well. Now, anytime really here on out until we remove this from our alerts watch list, if we have any one of these stocks breach our volatility box zones, that's either our long entry or our short entry zones, you'll get a browser-based notification that lets you take advantage of these moves in stocks that you have an overall longer-term bias on. Now you can repeat the same thing if you'd like inside of the squeeze signal as well, or the edge signals, or any other stocks that you really have some sort of bullish bias on. You can now add that inside of the platform and just let the platform do the work of notifying you anytime it appears on our live scanner. That means we've breached our volatility box zone. You have an opportunity to get in at a discounted price, and hopefully you have a move similar to LRCX, where in that same day you're up anywhere between 3 to 4% from your entry prices just because you did your homework, you had this bias, you had this overall longer-term bias, and now you had the intraday volatility to try and pinpoint that perfect reversal zone. All right, hope this video helps. Again, this is a repeatable process, so I hope you take advantage of it. Take care, everyone. Good luck trading, and we'll see you in the next update.